after years of fishing the Caney Fork. I'm still amazed at its beauty. On the surface, the clear, smoothly flowing water reflects the passing landscape. Underneath, it offers some of the best trout fishing anywhere.
Let's go hit the run, see if we can't catch some fish.
Nature's even provided its own audience for our fun today. Not surprising when you consider the abundant wildlife the Caney Fork supports.
Just another day in the office, Chris.
Joining me is Steve Nix, a fellow guide who's fly fished pretty much his whole life.
You gotta love cold mornings and good fishing.
Yep. What the rest of the world are doing.
Sitting in traffic.
Yep. On a cell phone.
This time of the year, female brown trout are on their beds, called reds. They're spawning, so it's important not to disturb them.
If you're going to fish on a red, do not target the female. Target the other male brown trout behind her or the rainbow trout that would be kind of hanging out behind the red as well.
With that in mind, brown trout can be a great catch.
They really can get a good big size in our tailwaters, and they're excellent fighters. They're fun to catch.
Ah, come on, Chris. Did you miss one too at the same time?
When you catch a brown trout, you know it. He goes down and shakes his head like a bulldog, and then when you least expect it, he comes rocketing out of the water and jumps. They're just mean fish and they're pretty.
Along with eating fish, they're also carnivorous, which means they'll eat insects and other small animals like crayfish, frogs, and salamanders. Large browns like deep water and prefer feeding at night. These days, there are lots of big browns in the Caney Fork, the result of excellent work to improve water quality by the Corps of Engineers and the TWRA.
It has created a really good fishery here on the Caney Fork, and it's been noticed in places besides Tennessee. People are traveling from other states to come down and fish it.
You know, most of the time, people that aren't familiar with the fish up here on the Caney Fork, they're used to catching the small stock fish. And when they see these monster brown trout laying out here, and there'll be four or five of them on a red cutting back and forth, they can't believe it.
It's easy to spot brown trout. They have a golden yellow, light brownish color with some red and black dots along their sides.
Come on, fish.
Brownies are not native to Tennessee, having originated in Europe thousands of years ago. Their first documented introduction in North America was in the early 1880s. Unfortunately, we had no big battles today.
Rusty, ooh, little brownie, little male.
What do you got here? Oh, little bow. All right, in the top of the lip where it's supposed to be. There we go. Get out of here.
Steve and I firmly believe that catch and release is the best way to have fun and ensure plenty of big fish for all anglers in the years ahead.
There we go. Ah!
You get what you deserve. Taking advantage of me because I'm tangled.
I gotta get you while I can.
No trophy fish hit our hooks. But just the sight of those big browns in the river is thrilling enough for me. There's no need to travel to faraway places for trophy trout when they're waiting for you right here in Tennessee.
Our data shows that the potential is there for 30 plus inch brown trout in many of our tailwaters. And there's fish that size that we see every year.
Believing, folks, or you can just leave more fish for my friend Steve and me to catch. You know, I can't think of a better way to spend my day.
No matter what's going on, you know, in your life or what's going on in the world, you can always escape here, always escape with a fly rod in your hand.
Couldn't have said it better myself. I'm Chris Nishan on Tennessee's Wild Side.